Hi, I'm Huida at the Innocence Project. I'm the case director here, and today we're talking about forensic DNA testing. DNA itself is a molecule that's found in every nucleated cell in the human body. It codes for all of our genetic traits. The vast majority, over 99% of our DNA, is actually identical. The part that isn't, the variations in the DNA sequence, is actually what determines our individuality and our individual traits. The structure of DNA is actually in a twisted ladder, which we call a double helix. And this is what it looks like when it's untwisted. So the molecule is actually made up of base pairs of nucleotides. In any investigation in which police believe that a biological sample was left behind, they can collect that biological sample, send it to a lab, and try to find the specific DNA sequence and specific DNA markers and compare it against suspects, victims. So, let's say the police find a bloody t-shirt at the scene. We want to know whose blood is on that shirt. So the police collect the shirt and send it to the lab. What happens at the lab? The sample of blood from the t-shirt is extracted, and we're going to look for the DNA on the shirt. So lab analysts run the amplified and extracted DNA through a machine that involves a chicken. Actually, it looks more like this. Sample goes into a machine, results are read by a laser after going through a capillary tube, and is interpreted by a computer. So the laser in the machine actually measures which markers are present and how much amplified DNA we have. The markers in forensic STR testing are different because of their lengths, and their lengths are different because of the number of tandem repeats, and tandem repeats are repeated sequences in the DNA strand. So let's say we take a sample from the suspect by taking a cheek swab and testing the cells in his saliva to get DNA profile at marker X. Let's say he turns out to be a 4 and an 8, because the blood on the shirt at marker X is a 3 and a 6, and he can't contribute what he doesn't have. We know that this suspect did not leave the blood on the shirt. So this was a super simplified version of forensic DNA testing. To learn more, check these links.